The home screen on Amazon devices have always been very, very nice. They've always been laid out nice, and they've actually went a step further and allowed you to scroll the home screen now, so you can go up and down. So it used to just look like this, and now you can scroll to reveal more, and that's really nice. These have been consistent for a couple generations now: home, back, settings, Goodreads, store, and so forth. Clicking on settings will bring up your Bluetooth, sync your Kindle, all settings, your airplane mode, auto brightness, because it has an auto light sensor on it, and you can change the glow light. We will show you that in a little while. You also have something here that just drops down: experimental browser. Yes, after 10 generations, it is still experimental. Settings, and so forth. The Barnes & Noble Nook has changed itself a couple times. They used to have an LCD screen at the bottom in the very beginning, and then they've gone through some UI changes since then. It is running Android, so you can click the top and bring down the little Android drop down. It's not running Android in the regard where you can install APKs and stuff, but it is skinned. You do have all settings as well. Clicking out gets new, recent, in my library, recommended for you, and then all the logos down below signify different things. This will be your library, your shop, what you're reading now, readouts, and then search. Going to your library, you do have all of your list of books. You can change it via grid or list, and the Amazon Oasis can do that as well, like so. They both have physical page turn buttons, although the Nook Glow Light Plus has 2x the amount of them, and that is because you can do right-hand or left-handed users, whereas this has a gyroscope in the device, so it relies on you switching it the way you want based on how you're holding it. You can change pages with the physical page turn buttons, swipe, tap, etc., although the Nook has a lot more functionality. For example, if you double tap one of the page buttons, you actually jump chapter by chapter, and that just holds true throughout the entire book, as well as sideloaded content, granted that the table of contents are, well, accurate. On the Kindle, you can't do that. It just changes pages. Although it changes it very quick, and refreshing is actually pretty low, and there's not a whole lot of staining. The Nook also has quick page turn, which we kind of would have thought the Oasis 2 would have had because of all the manga model engines that they've used on some of their other devices, like the Paperwhite and even the Kindle Basic 10th generation. They've had that, but they don't. But there is some stuff that they both kind of bring to the table on their own. For example, they both do long presses, they both do highlights, notes, share, search, and book, and they have different ways to define things. So they have dictionary, and they have read more, and they have Wikipedia entries and all that, but the Kindle takes it a step further. If you box a bunch of text, you can actually click here on the three little dots and click translation. From here, you can change it from any language to any language you see on the dropdown, and it changes in about 3 seconds. So this is actually extremely valuable because basically, you've broken down the barriers of not being able to read a book if it's not in your language. Finnish, Russian, Afrikaans, I don't even know where that is, Catalan, Icelandic. That's really cool because it's not word by word definition and then, you know, copy paste and going to the experimental browser and translating. It's built in. They both have ways to change the page, the font, the bold size, the margins. You can go through all of this: line spacing, justification, reading, themes, and so forth. PDFs on Amazon devices have been really clunky up until the Kindle Paperwhite 3. The Oasis has no such problem. It actually has really good pinch and zoom capabilities, and you do have a mini map on the top left corner showing you where you are on the page. It does take a little bit to render, and that is only because, well, it's an e-reader. You do have the ability to long press, and you have the ability to box basically all the text, and yes, use translation. So again, if I even have a sideloaded PDF, I can essentially read this if I only knew simplified Chinese and I didn't know English. And look at that, it does the whole book, it scrolls very, very quickly, and it's all there. It's actually through any book, any PDF, medical document, it works really well. Other than that, there aren't too many ways to change your page display. You can go contrast, margins, orientation. You don't even need to choose orientation because it has a gyroscope. The Barnes & Noble Nook, you can't pinch and zoom on it. And that was a little bit of a problem for us because, well, you can't double tap or change the scale of it at all. And if you try to long press, you can long press, it takes a little bit of time, and you do get all the options you'd get in an ebook. You get notes, you get highlights, you get copy. But other than that, there's not really any way to cater your PDF experience to yourself. Once you tap there, you only get a few options. You get table of contents, which doesn't always work because it is, well, side-loaded content. And then you get add bookmark, jump to page, find in book, and view details, which just shows you what file type it is, and it's a PDF. Other than that, you get a scroll bar, and that's where it ends with the PDF experience on the Nook. Amazon and Barnes & Noble both have a preloaded application, really. That's Goodreads and Nook Readouts. Nook Readouts is a daily selection of books and little excerpts and stuff that you can read across all platforms, too, whether you have the Nook Samsung devices or the Nook tablet or your e-readers. And Goodreads is a little community where you can like and comment and go through what other people are reading on shelves, recommendations, and even have friends on Goodreads. You can see right there, you can add them and delete them and all sorts of stuff. So it's like a little book community. And each of these have their own thing, but they don't have each other's. So you won't find Goodreads here, and you won't find Barnes & Noble Readouts here. We're not going to go through the entire UI of the store experience, but these are how you would purchase a book. This is how you would make your buying decision. They have your thumbnail in the same place, the title in the same place, review in the same place, but they go about it a little bit differently. Barnes & Noble uses a tabbed system, customer reviews, editorial reviews, and then more like this. And they'll each show you a different screen, although the top UI elements will not change. Whereas Amazon actually has everything under one roof. You actually scroll. So you can see the scroll bar on the side. You do have customer reviews. There's everything there. And then there'll be editorial reviews down below, product details, and so forth. And actually, I didn't even know that. If you get to the bottom, you can click back to the top. That's really cool. So this is how you can expect to be able to buy free sample, on all of your buying decisions for the Nook Marketplace and the Amazon Marketplace. The Nook's glow light has warm lighting or night mode, which means there's two sets of LEDs. So whereas the Kindle has just the blue LEDs, the Nook has blue and orange, and you can kind of turn them on like that. But what I've noticed and what we noticed in the studio here when we did our testing is that from about the 20% mark, it starts to turn really orange, and it's pretty much orange all the way through to this extreme Sunny D candlelight, and I don't know why they prioritized orange so deeply, whereas the white zone is so small, and then you just get to extreme blue. So there's actually a very small threshold in which you can get an actual white, and that lies right about there. You do have the ability to change the extremity as well, so how bright it is, and on the Kindle, you actually don't have warm lighting or any sort of other LED colors, you just have the main one. However, you do have auto brightness, so if you turn that on, which we're not going to do because it'll probably shut off in the dark, it goes a little squirrely sometimes, but auto brightness uses the light sensor on the bezel, and it allows the device to choose how bright it'll be. Actually, let's give it a shot. Oh, it almost turned off. Last time it turned off, so I didn't want to do that. Barnes & Noble and Amazon have been going at it for the past 10 years, and Barnes & Noble has had a ton of flops in the past 10 years. They've also had 11 tablets that they've released. Amazon seems to be doing the best job, and evidently and statistically, they are the best. They sell the most, they look great, and people love them, and they have so many different styles of devices. If you guys have any other questions, comments, or concerns, you want to hit us up on Facebook, let us know. We would love to answer any questions you have about these devices, but so far, these represent the latest offerings from Amazon and Barnes & Noble for GoodyReader.com, and a comparison between the Nook Glowlight Plus 7.8-inch, not to be confused with the 2015 Glowlight Plus, and the Kindle Oasis 2. This is Peter.